Dropping fine mare is coming clear to win this 4-year-old mare's maiden. So Kilbarry Leader, daughter of leading knight, could be
pieces. Winning rider of the first race, the 4-year-old mare's maiden, Chris O'Donovan. Well done, Chris. Kilbarry Leader, daughter of Leading Light. She was impressive today.
Yeah, I know. She travelled smoothly throughout. She was down coming into the home straight and she made a good way home. Jumped super. Seems to do everything easily. Seems a very nice mare for the future. She should go on to do things.
That's trained by Con O'Keefe. You mentioned to me earlier you were probably lucky enough to get on board this horse today.
Johnny Barry had a lot of schooling done with her and worked her, but he chose Ian McCarthy's mare, so the way it worked out, it was lucky.
Nice for you.
Yeah, no, it's great.
And whereabouts are you based out of now, Chris?
I'm kind of a good blessed. I go into Camp Keaton there and into Paul O'Flynn's, and I'll be always with Mick Winters whenever he's around. So yeah, I know I do plenty of riding out for people.
Nice to get off the mark for the season then.
Yeah, I know, it's great to get off the board.
On home ground.
Especially early enough, makes it easier.
That's good. Listen, well done today.
Thanks, Millie.
The final fence, Starovich takes over. Pictures here at the last piece. It goes on by 2 lengths. As they go up to the finish, is East Harlem, and then Earth's Fury is running on strongly, but Starovich has the lead. Earth's Fury is closing.
Barry O'Neill, winning rider of the 4-year-old Geldon's Maiden on Starovich, a son of Sindar for Colin Bow. Barry, well done. He was impressive and he looks like a very classy horse.
Yeah, Dave, look, he probably would have been a winner before lockdown. His work had been very good and he done everything nicely at home. Look, he's a nice horse. He's an exceptional jumper. Did it easy. He pricked his ears at the back of the last, so all over the horse does that. He seems to have plenty in the tank and won cause in the end. So look, he's a nice horse going forward for new connections. Hopefully he got to sales now.
The Corsair, who eyeballed him, but he's up through the lead again. He's just up from Menko the Corsair coming down to the middle track on the outside. James Cannon versus Ben Harvey. It's going to be yes, governor by half a length of Menko the Corsair is the go to the line.
Winning rider of the first division of the 5-year-old Geldon's Maiden. Well done, James. Yes, governor for Joe Ryan. Good finish in the end, battled out and won well.
Thanks, Davey. Yeah, it was lovely. Great way to start off the year for me. Kind of local enough track for Joe Ryan. He's been very, very good to me, and the house is very, very tough, and he toughed it out all the way up the straight, and he won well.
It was a good finish between the two of his after he's jumped the back of the last.
Twas, I know Pat Doyle thinks a fair bit of his house, so our house was tough, and I love the way he put his head down and galloped and jumped all the way up the straight.
Like you said, James, only for a fourth weekend in, so good to get off the mark.
Great to get off the mark, yeah. Lovely, so good start to the year.
And you're busy?
I am. I'm very busy and doing a lot of schooling and galloping. Just nice if we could get a bit of galloping and grass and schooling and grass. All these horses might be lacking a little gallop or school and grass at the moment, but we've only to work with what we have and we're getting on grind. So,
The mare's maiden there, the last race that we watched.
Yeah.
Did you go the inside or the outside?
Oh, I went to the outside. Turned the bend and it looked like we were being directed both directions and it's very tight. So myself and Barry went to the outside. We finished first and second. It just a lot of confusion with the fence yards on the day.
Yeah, that's good. Listen, well done today, James.
Great. Thanks very much. Thanks.
From Gallo Ford, Deep Dancer, Gallo Ford, they want some beers and tea. Deep Dancer, Gallo Ford, Gallo Ford, Deep Dancer, living between them as they hit the wire.
And the second division of the 5-year-old Geldon's Maiden, Gallo Ford, son of Wester for Colin as well. And he made a mistake at the last, but once you got over onto the rail, then he battled well for you.
Yeah, we went a very fast pace throughout, Dave. He was dropped in there and he actually jumped very, very well up to that. He's a horse there, he's a big, weak horse. He took a couple of runs and things like that. He was good and tough today, and he'd probably go for maybe going for a winner's race, just to show people like that he's not too bad, and hopefully go on.
Chances are now, Hador and Chris Brad have ended up like a dancing carrier who's coming home well, but Hador finds a bit more for Conor Costello. Chris Brad is coming back on the inside, as is the dancing farrier who's finishing best of all. The dancing farrier,
winning rider of the winners of two race, Richie Kiley. Well done, Richie. The dancing farrier had to battle well at the back of the last to get back up on the line.
Yeah, he did, Dave. He done it well. He actually quickened up well from the back of the second last. Got right under the last. I knew I'd probably had enough going to the last not to really need to fire Matt. He was slow over and he picking up well to the line. He done it well enough in the end, I thought.
He pulled up the last day amongst grains. Is there any reason behind that?
The ground was fractionally quicker there than it is today. I'd say he didn't enjoy it. But we knew going, he was badly in the need of an outing. So we're a little disappointed, but we kind of had our reason.
Because he had a good run in Ballyragget before that then.
He did, yeah. And like, he was ready to rock and roll then. He was entered the weekend that Everton was stopped. And obviously he was left off out in the field then. That was his first run back last week. So no, he stepped forward nicely actually now.
He's a right horse to have for these sort of races, isn't he?
He'll hold his own, sure. He can run another winner or two now. Maybe later on in the year, if he improved another little bit, he could contest something like a Maiden Hunter Chase or something like that. And like, he could pay his way for the rest of the year, hopefully.
Any busy at home, Richie?
We're tipping away. We've maybe 15 riding out between maybe 10 to run and a few breakers and a few pre-trainers coming and going. So we're busy, yeah. We're tipping away nicely, yeah.
Good. Listen, well done today.
Thanks, Dave.
She was good, wasn't she?
Yeah, she was good. She had a nice run around here in a 4-year-old maiden. Robert liked her. He thought she wouldn't be far away today. Really loved the ground. It jumped exceptional. She came up the straight with Owens in hand. It'd be a shame if she did have to lose the race, but look, we'll have to go by the rule book and see what happens down the line.
That's good. A good day today, and three winners for yourself and three for Colin. He had a winner in Loughrea as well, Tommy's Oscar, who you've rode a few times. So Colin's had a good weekend as well.
Yeah, the horses seem to be in great form. As you said, Tommy's Oscar won there on Galway today. It was good to see him getting his head in front, because he's been knocking on the door there plenty. Navy Girl yesterday, she was good. She was a Western mare there. She was on the way to the sales, and this race popped up for her, so we let her take her chance, and she won slowly. And I'd imagine she'd go to the sales now as well.
And yesterday you had the double, as you mentioned, Navy Girl. You won on a nice Scirocco horse on debut for Andrew Latta, who battled well.
Yeah, they went a good gallop up there. Andrew fancied him going, jumped great, was very tough from the top of the hill home, but he really put it to bed when he got his head in front, and you could see at the line like he was going away. So definitely a nice horse for new connections. Hopefully he'll go to the same as the previous horse. Hopefully he'll go to sales and go on, and the owners have plenty of fun.
That's good. Well done, Barry. Another good weekend.
Thanks, Dave.
Win 6-year-old and upwards maiden, Pa King. Well done, Pa. Reinvent for Sam Curlin. Bit of a, all it turned out to be was a match in the end, but sure, all you can do is do what you've done.
Yeah, actually, he just had to beat while I was there, but he did a nice, a couple of nice runs last year. A
couple of seconds, hadn't he?
Yeah, and he was running on very heavy ground. His bio race is dream, so.
Yeah.
He had a grand run in Oldcastle. I was going to be second, he just got very tired from second last home. So it was a nice run. I thought if everything turned up, he'd still be hard to beat, but sure, you can only beat us there. The other horse had two good runs in Bumper, so.
Johnny Barry rode the other horse. What's your thinking when you go into a race like that when it's only a match?
Look, Johnny said it was his first run in the White Wine. He said he wanted to follow me. Nice and fine. My dad was an experience. He popped away nicely all the way. I thought if I didn't try and keep it simple enough that I'd win. So, you know, I didn't try and go too hard or quickened up well over the last couple. He's jumping. He was just a bit better than the other horse jumping over the last couple. He was able to win easy. So, nice.
You won a region title last year, Pa, and that's your second winner this season, so things are going well for you.
Yeah, it's a nice start to the season there. So,
your first winner was amongst grains, wasn't it?
Yeah, nice 5-year-old for my diet. So
I missed you that day.
I didn't hang around too long.
Sam has plenty of good horses as well there for the year ahead. So
Look, we're getting out a couple there to run a nice ground, but you know, it's still a bit quick for the nicer horses. Yeah. So hopefully we'll get a nice drop of rain and we'll start letting the nicer ones run.
That's good. Listen, well done today, Pat.
Great, Dave. Thanks very much.